Hey guys, this is Clouds, and I'm back with another round breakdown. This time we're playing Rush on Dragon Valley as a defending team. As you can see, I've got the AA mine equipped, and I also have a Stinger equipped. I definitely prefer to use an anti-air setup on at least these first couple of bases, because the attackers get a scout heli, which can cause quite a lot of havoc, especially if the pilot is decent. Due to the nature of these first couple of bases on this Temple Island, the helicopter has a lot of cover. It can easily move to either side of the island, so if it's getting locked on the west side, it can just hover over to the east and vice versa. And in addition to that, all of the trees and buildings can get in the way of a lock. For some reason I figured there were, you know, small transport vehicles coming in, so I thought why not switch to the law. Unfortunately, I've only got 24 HP, and this guy, the 7.62 miniguns can kill you pretty quick, especially when you only have 24 HP. Unfortunately, my squad gets wiped. We're down four players. Four players, I know it doesn't sound huge, but that's about a squad. So we're down a squad. They've got both MCOMs armed. I forget, there's no way we're going to push up. So I might as well just prepare for the second base. As you can see, I've got my double mine setup. I really like this setup. The reason I'm using it is the attackers get an Amtrak, and on the first base, it doesn't really come into play because it can't easily get up to the MCOMs. But the Amtrak is very important on this second base, and putting down mines to impede its progress to the MCOMs is very important. You'll see here I'm putting some mines down at this little opening near the river where I think the Amtrak might come up. And now I'm heading to a little defensive position. This, you know, and these rocks can make for good hiding spots. And I have great, you know, great sight on Alpha, so I can keep eyes on it pretty easily. Now see, most of my team is on Bravo, and with these MCOMs, because they're so far, they're on both sides of the islands, if you have one MCOM that only has like a couple people looking at it, it's probably gonna get taken out pretty quickly. I see this guy on the minimap shoot at me, and I thought for some reason that he ran this way, but he was still in that tree. One of my teammates comes to get him, but he kills that guy too. And now they're on Alpha. Switching back to the Stinger. And you see, because there are only like two or three people looking at Alpha, so once it gets armed, enemy team is pretty much guaranteed to take it. And at this point, I'm too far from Alpha. I can't run over there, kill the enemy, and then defuse, so I make my way towards Bravo. Trying to get a lock on this scout heli. Yeah, these trees, they can make it quite hard to get a lock on. After a while, I figure, okay, I'm not going to get the heli, so I'll push up to Bravo. Enemy team gets it rearmed. And as I'm heading up that way, I'm pretty sure I get hit by a grenade. Yeah, and then I see more grenades coming on to the MCOM, so there's no way I'm going to be able to get that. So I push back, hopefully to kill these enemies. Look at this, I'm sliding down this hill. Wow. Dude, these slippery hills in the valley, they're quite treacherous, I gotta say. Very treacherous indeed. Okay, so we're on the third base. I'm doing quite bad, but don't worry. I redeem myself. I pick it up. So on this base, there's some good things and some bad things for the defenders. The good thing is that it's very far away from the attacker's spawn, so they have to cross a very long section of the map. And in addition to that, they don't have a lot of cover getting up to the SIMCOM. Unfortunately, oh, look at this, the scout heli flying very low and flanking to get behind the MCOMs, using the trees as cover. I get in here and I just stand still because I thought maybe someone will bail out of the helicopter and try to arm Bravo. After a while, I see that's not happening, so I chase after the helicopter. And you'll see here what I said about the trees. You see, that's the ECM. I get a lock on, but either the Stinger missile hit a building or maybe a tree. And if a scout heli pilot is smart enough, they can pretty easily evade Stinger missiles on this map. Especially when it's just one Stinger user. I mean, you'll see here, I get a lock, I fire, but through some clever maneuvering, that guy evades the missile again. And one of the bad things about this base for the defending team is the MCOMs are very far apart. I think they might be at least 100 meters apart from each other. So you can't easily just sort of watch both. You have to make a decision. Okay, am I going to watch Alpha or am I going to watch Bravo? And this scout heli, I think he spotted where that missile came from, so he knows where I'm at and he takes me out. And I know someone's going to say, oh man, if you had an RPG, if you weren't a Stinger noob, you could have RPG'd that guy. Maybe. But you know, I have been distracting and annoying him with the Stingers, so even if you don't get kills on the heli, annoying it and keeping it back, you know, it's helpful for your team. Oh, watch this. You'll never guess what happens. Look at this. Look at the kill feed. My squad mate DD Rich shoots the pilot out with his G18. Wow. Well done. Well done indeed. Unfortunately, I have mines equipped, so I can't really repair him. I'm not really that useful, so I bail out pretty quickly. Find this enemy spawn beacon. I switched to my suppressed G18. Always good to have a suppressed weapon to take out enemy equipment. And I see Bravo's arm, so now I'm heading that way. Unfortunately, the path that I'm taking to Bravo, it has basically no cover. So I can't just run in there. I see there's like 5 or 6 enemies. I can't get that. So we're left with Alpha. Although we're not in a horrible position because we get him down to 55 tickets. Oh, you'll see, this is weird. I'm putting slams. I get taken out. You know, normally if you put slams on an enemy vehicle, as soon as it starts moving, they will detonate. But I don't think it happens with this Amtrak. I don't know. That was weird. Don't have to worry about a scout heli anymore, so I switch to an RPG. Now I'm heading down to take care of that Amtrak. After I take care of the beacon. Okay, so I'm in a good spot because these guys will not be expecting me back here. And you know what I should have done is put slams on the butt and then shoot it with an RPG. But if I did that, I would get an RPG kill, and I really wanted a slam kill. So my hubris, well, it kind of bit me in the butt. I take these guys out, but See, now I'm behind the enemy. and I've got a silenced, well, suppressed weapon, so these guys don't see me. But I make a mistake. I don't pay attention to my ammo count, so I rush in with 2 bullets left. Get killed pretty quickly. Teammate gives me a revive. Now, he does give me a 20%, but the entire area is cleared of the enemy, so I think in those type of situations, giving a 20% revive is understandable. Oh, look at this. The enemy team has flanked us. Like I said, I don't know if I've mentioned it yet, but this entire rush map has great flanking opportunities for the attackers. They can get right behind the MCOMs very easily. Oh no, there's a beacon down there. I don't know if you saw it on the minimap, but there's a beacon down near that tree. That's a good spot for a beacon. Alright, unfortunately, DD got taken out. But we've got him down to 13 tickets. So we're not in a horrible situation. Although the enemy team, from the looks of it, is swarming Alpha. There's a lot of smoke. I looked to my left here. I heard a suppressed weapon firing. So I was like, whoa, is that an enemy? Okay, it's not. Enemy's still down near this hill. I get shot in the back. I don't know if that guy was on the rooftop or what, but it was in a good spot. And it took me out. And the enemy gets the third base with 0 tickets left. Wow. Nicely done, enemy team. Okay, so I'm switching to my double mines. My double mine technique. I love this technique. This tactic. At this base, the attackers get some, I don't know if it's like quads or desert patrol, they get some type of little jeeps that can zip up to these MCOMs, so you definitely want to have some mines down. Ideally, I would have the more deployed explosives perk active, so I could have 6 AT mines and 6 slams, but instead I can only have 3 ATs and 3 slams, which, you know, that's alright. Put those mines down on the main road, and you'll see I've positioned myself up here a little bit past Bravo. This is an amazing flank route. It doesn't get a lot of traffic, so if you stay here, you're not going to get like a bunch of kills, but it's a very important area to watch, because if just one guy gets past this little area, they can go all the way around behind Bravo. They can go all the way right up to the defending spawn. And if they get some beacons back there, man. Game over, dude. So I'm patrolling this section of the map while also being wary of that other western area towards Alpha. You'll look on the minimap, most of my teammates are behind Alpha, which it's not a great spot to be in. You kind of want to be a little bit closer up towards the MCOMs. Still moving around, spotting enemies to hopefully help my teammates near Alpha, while also paying attention to this area. Alright, so Alpha gets armed. I head that way, but I start getting shot at, and my teammates defuse it, so I figure, okay, I'll get out of there. Getting really suppressed right now. And hit. I think my squadmate, he spots this guy, and I think he puts some shots on him, because when I do engage this dude, I kill him pretty quickly, so I think he's already hurt. Now, unfortunately, I'm hurt real bad, and I ask for a medkit. This guy doesn't care. And at this point, I'm like, alright. I think it's time to switch squads. So, I do that. Yeah. Okay, you'll see I've made a little edit. and that's because this was recorded with the PS4 Share button. I think I mentioned this before, but it has a 15-minute time limit. So it's not a huge deal because you can just hit record right after, but even if you hit record as fast as you can, as soon as you get the little prompt that says, hey, you're no longer recording, there's a little gap. So yeah, I just thought I'd mention that. Anyway, you see we've lost Alpha, so that's not good. I head over, because obviously if we lost Alpha, there's some enemies that way. But I get taken out. And yeah, in a short amount of time, this base has gone completely tits up. We've lost Alpha, Bravo's armed. Most of the defending team was squad wiped, or they chose. I assume most of us were squad wiped, and that's why we're spawning back at our deployment. Or maybe some of these guys were just sitting here. I don't know. I'm making my way up towards Bravo as fast as I can, but it's not enough, and they take the base. I'm not a fan of spawn camping, and I don't know if you would call it spawn camping, because it's like we just lost the base, and so obviously we're over here, so we might as well try to take, you know, a few of their tickets. But yeah, I get RGO'd. So now we've been pushed back to the final base, which you'll see here I'm switching to a DMR. That's because this base has, I think it has the most long range engagements of any of these bases on this map. So I'm setting it up. Oh, you're going to be so disappointed with me. I know what you're thinking. Oh, you have time to fix up your loadout, but you can't spend another 2 seconds to switch to the swagged out orange camo? Really? Really, Clouds? Yeah, I just wanted to spawn in as fast as possible. I'm sorry. I don't have the cool orange camo, so forgive me. And you'll see one of the bad things about this base. The defenders, they spawn up on that hill, which, I mean, it's a decent spot, but when you have a sizable portion of the defending team just sitting up there, it doesn't help your team at all. So, like, I'm up here, I'm by myself, I get taken out pretty quickly. I think that hill area, it's a decent spot if you have, like, maybe one dude on a bipodded 200-round LMG, and then maybe a really good sniper, perhaps, but having like 4 or 5 people up on this hill, I know I'm camping on this hill, but that base was just, we're not going to get that MCOM, so I figured I might try to spot these guys and maybe get a kill. But you'll see, after I get a kill, I'm like, okay, we got to push up. Now, this MCOM base, the attackers, they have sort of two main ways to the MCOM base. They have that upper walkway along the dam, and then there's this wooden bridge. Now, the wooden bridge, it's to my left here. It doesn't get a whole lot of traffic, but it's very important to watch as a defender, because even if just one guy gets through there, you know, then he puts down a beacon in one of these buildings. Wow, look at how rusty I am with the DMR. That was pretty bad. Yeah, like these guys. Definitely want to watch this wooden bridge. See a blueberry also watching this area, so good for him. See, when I'm doing like controlled tap, tap, taps, yeah, I'm not horrible with the DMR, but, you know, I was just a little rusty. Okay, I make a big mistake here. If you look on the minimap, you can clearly see two enemy players parachute down. Look at that. Look at the minimap. They're right there, but I don't pay attention. So, I mean, you can't keep your eyes glued to the minimap 24/7, but always good to look down at that, especially when you if you have like sort of a feeling that the enemy might be somewhere. Oh, look at this, getting shot in the back. This is a great position for an attacker to be in, because the defenders are, you know, they're jumping down from that hill, and you're not expecting an enemy to be right at the base of that hill. So that's a good spot. And you'll see one of these guys, Pablo, putting down a beacon behind the MCOM. Okay, so kind of just getting my bearings, looking up here. I spot one enemy. I'm just trying to get a feel for like where the enemy's at. Look over to the bridge. Okay, that's clear. Enemy gets an arm though somehow. This guy, I don't know who that is. That was a ninja arm. That was definitely, oh wow, this is so bad. I thought there might be like one guy in here, but there's three. These guys are very sneaky. I did not expect three people in that room. And you're gonna be real disappointed in me, because guess what? I make the same exact mistake. Well, not the same, because this time, it's on me. Like, that first encounter, like right there, like how was I supposed to know that there were three people in that room? But here, look, the enemies are, look at the minimap. There's clearly like five enemies right around this little concrete wall. But for some strange reason, I choose to engage them when I had no chance of taking them out. Okay, so I see that there's like five enemies there, and I think to myself, oh, we gotta flank that. We gotta do that now. Still have a couple teammates camping the hilltop. So I'm headed that way. Guess what happens? Look at this clever bastard. He's right, yeah, that's that same spot. That's a good spot. I mean, it's out in the open, but still, this spot. So I'm headed this way. Unfortunately, I got spotted. So one of these guys is watching this area. I throw down a grenade just on that section in case I get rushed. And as I'm waiting for my health to regen, I'm just putting some shots down on the enemy. You'll see here, once I get to this section, the enemy has either been killed or they've pushed up. And some of them pushed up because guess what? They get it armed. Look at these slippery hills, dude. Oh my god. I get killed again by these muddy slip. I need better boots, man. Jeez. But we get it defused. Good job, team. Good job. And look at this. I started off so horribly, but I don't get MVP, but I get top score for my team. So, not trying to brag, but you know, that's pretty good. Also, look at this. I've said this before. If you get MVP on the losing team, like exhale, you put the team on your back. That dude, he did pretty good. Like I said, I've said this before. I don't know if you watched my Dragon Valley review video, but I said it in that video. Dragon Valley Rush, oh man, it's so good. I like it so much. It's a really balanced map. You know, the MCOMs, they're spaced at a good distance, and it offers a lot of flanking opportunities. Man, I just can't sing the praises of Dragon Valley Rush enough. Oh, and in addition to that, no parachute spawns from the radio beacons. Wow, thank you. That's so good. That's so good. So yeah, Dragon Valley Rush, I'm a very big fan. It's quite good. You know, if you don't have it yet, it's free. Just search Legacy Operations. You'll find it. Yeah, if you have any thoughts or comments on this round, or on Dragon Valley Rush, or on Dragon Valley in general, let me know. Always interested to hear your thoughts. And thanks for watching. Bye.